Hello, welcome back to Let's Play a Tear of Vermillion, Legend of Heroes, stuff like that. Blind. Alright, we're leaving Karuna Village. I guess we're heading back to Guia, which is south. Not too far. So we'll do that. Should we kill some of these things? Why not? Rapoopy and Rock Monkey. Oh, we got our new friend with us, though. So that'll be cool. We got Spirit Undying. Let's try that out. And Black Magic. I'm not going to be able to reach any of them, so... I'm a genius. Let's just attack this time. Yeah, let's attack this one. Check out... something about nurture me, show yourself. That's pretty cool. Ouch. We got full attack meters, but these things are already damaged. It would kind of be a waste. Okay. Let's kill this one too. Why not? Some practice in here. Happy pet! Yeah. Alright, Sonic Sword. Flamethrower. I'm gonna be able to reach this one, but what are you gonna do? How about this? Oh, he's running away from her. Let's go. Let's go back. I'm getting a little lost. Been a while since we've been down here. It's actually been, admittedly, a little while since I've even played this, so I'm trying to remember where to go. I know it's south, but it's like a winding road's house. Hopefully this... we need another sign. This is a dead end, I think. Or maybe not. Oh, I like this part. Back to, is this Anil Highway? Tell me where Guia is. East. So it should be right over here then. We require the Guia. All right, good. Oops. I was wondering, like, are we gonna know what to do when we get here? The worker's yelling, help! Let me guess, it's a problem with the factory. Whoops. Oh god, there's a monster. Eleanor says, Marshall showed up in town? Miles says, it's exactly what Fatima said. Avon says, we'll save that worker first. Here we go. Lightning fast. Oh no! Please, someone help me! Hold on! We're coming! Are you okay? Says Mile. Thank you. You saved my life. What happened? Asks Avon. A swarm of monsters came in out of nowhere. We managed to evacuate the residents, but most of the houses were destroyed by them. Why the heck did it happen? Says Avon. Who are you? Rael says, hey, that's the guy that stole the Book of Life from me. Uh-oh, casting a spell? What the hell? Oh, is he summoning? Oh, he's like, those are like pentagram type things? Or whatever we use in this world? He summoned those things. Eleanor says, this is terrible. You summon monsters using the power of the evil text. Man, the mask says nothing and says runs away. Like the coward that he is. Alright. Well, I don't know if this is gonna be a tough battle or what. Some of us are not at full strength. What are you gonna do? The Rapoopy shouldn't be a problem. I don't know about these Mestis. I can't say that. Let's just kill him. It's easier. Alright, she'll do this thing. The spirit magic. The undying. I'll focus on that one right now. Ugh. Those nurture life. Oh wow, we did pretty good against those. Moving up! Boom. Which one was damaged? I'm not even sure. I think this one? Just in case there isn't something else waiting for us right after this. Well, Rael needs a lot of help here. He only knows black magic, yeah. How about Electro Cube on them? Heavenly Anger, crash, 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 the snack is still pudding. Nice, just one to go. Alright, we didn't get the heal Rael. Hopefully that's not a problem. Because I'm sure we're taking control again here. Oh, we can move, never mind. I thought we were going to ride into another cutscene. Please get rid of other monsters too. You're our only hope. No. So he ran off this way. I guess we'll head this way. Let's save. Yeah, it's been a little while since I played. Where are the monsters? Ah! Impulse Sybil? Hmm. What's your impulse shiver about? Alright, so everyone on this one. And we'll use a magical boom finishing move on the other one. This is filled with my magic. Magical boom. Yeah. Mm. Not too bad, not too bad. Alright, I guess we gotta go in every house and defeat. Yeah. Looks like. Where's all the people that were in these houses? Hiding somewhere? I think every time we're at a different spot. It's pretty interesting. Let's all pile in the Methodist B for now. How dare you? I'll kill you twice. You furry monstrosity. Alright, so we've cleared out this house. Clear out all the houses here. Angry Pat, nice. Boom. Just gonna save the magic for now. You missed. Way to miss. Nice. Eleanor is going to level up soon. I think she's going to be leaving us soon. I just have that feeling. The party members here just come and go so quickly. Like, I barely knew you. What happens if we try to leave? Miles says, we don't have time going back to New Borin. We must drive away the monsters quickly. Yes, indeed. Just wanted to see what he would say. Alright, monsters in here. Yep. Got that Cyclops thing here. Nice. That's the one time I like an angry Pat. The rest of the time, well, I can do without it. Oops. Must heal him immediately. It's blocked. How do we get in there? Oh. Let's get a locked door and a door that you can get through. That's weird. Yes! We like it that. Angry Pet. We kill. Alright, she's got a full meter. Crystal robe? What does that do? Unfortunately, I don't know if there's a way you can find out in combat of what these things do. Used to be you could hit a button. I think that's in Prophecy of the Moonlight Witch. Yeah, you can't see here. So I'll do it. Why not? We'll do that thing. A shield for us. Something. Okay, that's neat. Increasing defense. That still doesn't help. It's not magic defense. It must be regular attack defense. So you have zero there. But that would be helpful against a boss. Boss battle. I'm not gonna bother unconfusing him. Just gonna wait till the battle is over. Oh, he's hitting her. What a naughty boy you are. Yay, Eleanor levels up to 15. Rail's not far behind. Okay, so you're returned to us, right? Yeah, we would say something here. That's so funny that there's this door here that can't be opened. Oh, there's a whole bunch in there. Look at that. They're like having dinner or something. We're intruding on them. How rude of us. Oh wait, he's got the full meter. Wait. Flamethrow on this one. And then... a magical boom on the Rapoopy Bee. Oh, it lives! Wow. Oh, ouch. 40 points. Nice, one down. Two down. Rapoopy B has got to be, like, almost dead. Is this even... I'll let Rail finish off the poopy then. There you go. One left. We kill it. Rail, level 15 now. Sweet. Sweet 5 peers or whatever. Speaking of Rail, says, I guess we've trashed most of them now. Avon says, how could he do this kind of thing? Why did he release the monsters? Miles says, by the way, I remembered strange guys visiting the plant manager. They may have something to do with it. Right, let's go and ask the plant manager. Okay. Where'd all the people in the houses go? That's what I want to know. Come out now. I got rid of them. There's no more to get, right? Oh, who is that over there? They're still over there. One of the guards, I think. I don't remember the green hair, but it's been a while. Are there any monsters in here? Oh, Aven, Mile, I'm sure you've already heard. We have a grave problem. Since Max is not here, we only have you to count on. Aven says, we know. We'll try our best to get rid of the monsters ourselves. Thank you. You're our only hope. Just call us Skywalker. Oh, he found something. Too late. Hi. Weapons are for situations like this. Yeah, we have them, though. I don't think we need anything from you. Unless you have new stuff. I'm not looking right now. Despite the incident, we are open for business. We have a lot of rare potion, too. We don't need that. We don't need the ones we have. Let's see what everybody has to say. Hick, I feel so good. Eleanor says, Professor Maggot, I thought you had skipped your lectures today because you had a cold. Well, Professor Eleanor, there's a reason that is deeper than the ocean and higher than the mountain. I'm not here to question your act. I have a favor to ask. If monsters come attacking, could you please drive them away using your spells? Oh, that's easy. I won't let a single monster get inside. Rest assured and do what you must do. Are you sure we can trust him, says Aven, I guess in a low voice. Rael says he's a talented sorcerer, although not as good as me. No, of course not. Oh, all the people are here, hiding out. The bartender says, our place became a refugee camp. I hear the next door neighbor is also taking in people who ran for their safety. Well, there's the answer to my question. I'm glad we took a look. I want the monsters to go away soon. Well, we want the monsters to go away now. Although we aren't doing anything about it just a second. We're just talking, everybody. Old Man Basso says, you vexing monsters. If I was 10 years younger, I would have hammered them into gooey bars. Sorry, guys. Gooey bars? When the eerie-looking person began chanting, many monsters appeared from around. It was like I was seeing a nightmare. A nightmare, I tell you. When I was preparing dinner, the monsters suddenly came into the house. I ran for my life. I'm sure the monsters ate my cooking. I put in a lot of effort and time to cook a delicious meal for my husband. I can't forgive them. Mouse says, please calm down. We'll certain avenge your loss. Why is Miles stuttering? Hey, how is the factory? My father, he hasn't come back yet. I had arranged a monster cart and loaded all steels. When I was ready to leave Guia, the monsters appeared. I'm so unlucky. I'm pretty busy. I must cook delicious meals for my guests. People get more anxious when they are hungry. Oh yeah, I guess so. Takes the edge off if you have something to eat. When I was soliciting customers, the monsters showed up out of the blue. I have never been frightened like that in my life. I don't think she has anything to say. No. A lot of people here, I'm telling you. Alright, so next door is more refugees. What is it? Engineer Dalton. The moment the man in mask began chanting, the monster showed up and began wreaking havoc. Is it the power of a spell, Professor Eleanor? She says, yes, it's a deplorable example of how a spell can be misused. As a person who knows sorcery, I can't let him go unpunished. Please leave this to us. Misuse of a spell. Will a day ever come when machinery technology is misused? Probably. I wonder if Miruru is okay. Was she eaten by the monsters? I don't even know who that is. The monsters came into the residential area, so we came into this house to take refuge. Running away with my daughter was the only thing I could do. I don't know if my husband is alright at the factory. Bartis, please protect my husband. We don't know who released the monsters. Whoever it is should meet someone instead of getting involved in such a despicable act. Oh, she's the one who, like, hooks people up. She's the matchmaker type. So say go on a date instead of releasing monsters? I mean, kind of a stretch, but don't you agree, Professor Eleanor? I have no comment. I still have no comment. Anyone down here? Nope. All this space goes unused. Can't even read the books, I noticed that. Not that I'm looking to read books at this time. Oh, you're fine. I don't need that. No, we need to get up here. Is there anyone down this way? No. Oops, I fell right off. I want to see what Miles says. Eleanor says, let's go to the factory. We must consult Plant Manager Castle. Alright, let's go to Plant Manager Castle. Miles says, look! The gatekeepers are in trouble, says Rail. They knocked unconscious. I thought they looked funny. Avon says, hey, are you alright? Don't worry, says Eleanor. It's only a minor injury. Oh, you! Don't move, says Miles. I'll treat your wound. Don't worry about us. The men in masks and a fat guy who looked like a sorcerer went into the factory. What? Says Avon. Yeah! Says Rail for some reason. Miles says, something must have happened in the factory. Gee, whatever gave you that idea? Gatekeeper says, the plant manager and workers are in danger. Please go and rescue them quickly. Alright, says Avon. Leave it to us. The gatekeeper is unconscious. Please save the people at the factory. Okay, at least the song ended. Look, there's fire, says Rail. We must put it out, Miles says. Leave it to me, says Eleanor. Those who flow and foster life, I invite you to come out of the glassy surface of water. Appear, undying. Oh, cool. That's a good application of magic. Wow, you did it, Professor Eleanor, says Rail. Fire is spreading further. Let's put out every fire like this. Please, Professor Eleanor, says Mile. Okay, Avon says, we'll move on. Well, there's a juddery movement down the stairs. Oh, that sorcerer says, "This is my last warning. Are you going to build rare metal weapons for us or not?" Black Manager Castle says, "I said many times already, refinement of rare metal is an unknown territory. Even if we succeed, what we may have is a crystal of the size of a bean. We can't mass produce it in the quantity required to build weapons." The sorcerer says, "Make it a plant-wide project. You have talented engineers, don't you?" Castle says, "Guia's industrial technology exists to bring peace to Elfelden. I have no intention to collaborate with people whose job is to disturb peace." "The aim of Octum's apostles is to create true peace. It's a great pity you don't understand it. You, go and destroy the blast furnace." "What?" says Castle. Ruka says, "Please, don't. The HF-1 is a high-output blast furnace. If it runs out of control, the entire factory will be engulfed in fire." Sorcerer says, "Anything that's not ours should not exist. That is the providence of Octum." Sounds pretty selfish of you. "If you love your factory, why don't you stay here and burn with it?" "How could you?" says Ruka. Castle says, "You wicked masks." "It must be really beautiful. Something built by the sweat of your ancestors will go up in smoke in an instant. We also obtained the Book of Life. Our trip to Guia wasn't waste after all." Ruka says, "Father, Mother, Rutis, no, I won't ever lose people I love again. Wah!" Oh. Yeah, I didn't think that would go out very well. Castle says, "What have you done? Ruka, are you alright?" "Stupid kid. I remember. He's the brother of that girl. It's perfect. Kill him, too." Oh, boy. Avon says, "We won't let you!" Oh, he, like, jumped on the magical blast? "Ho-ho! You blocked my spell!" Avon says, "You must be a member of Octum's Apostles." "Are you challenging me, knowing who I am? You've got some nerves, young man. Let's see if you can take this one." A girl's voice says, "Please, stop." "Oh, you," says Avon. "Is that the princess?" "Oh, no, it's Rutis. I was waiting for you, Rutis," says the sorcerer. "Master Borgide. Borgide? I thought we had an agreement. I wasn't aware of this plan." "That's because I didn't tell you. Evil Oracle Borgide. I'm gonna say it Borgide. I am just following the order of Lord Belius." "Even if it's his order," Rutis says, "our enemy is the Bardas Church. Octum won't allow us to involve innocent people." "Octum is the god of purification. He burns all those low-life insects who don't question society and continue to live their worthless life without a sense of mission." Rutis says, "How dare! Your faith may be genuine, but you aren't tough enough. Are you worried about your brother, Ruka?" "You knew," she says. "Lord Belius told me. He said I could kill Ruka if that would make you tougher." "Thank Lord Belius for his paternal love." "Oh, really? Is Belius their father?" "No. You're lying," Ruta says. "Master Belius can't have said that." "Watch your mouth, girl. I don't understand why Lord Belius favors a newcomer like you. I didn't like you from the beginning." Okay, maybe he's not their father. Just the way he said paternal love like that, I thought he was a actual paternal figure in their family. "I'm going to send you and your brother off to the other world together." "The other world?" A low voice says, What a strong solidarity you have in Octum's Apostles. I wonder if it's the man with the blue bandana. What? It is. I forget his name. Madrum, right. Says, come on. No, he's defeating all of them in short order. Borgi says, who are you? I am a departed soul. I revenge on light and darkness. What the hell does that mean? I revenge on light and darkness? Evil Oracle Borgid, I shall kill you. Borgid laughs and says, we have an unexpected guest. Very well, why don't I kill you all? Uh-oh. He's throwing spells all over. Yeah, ha ha, burn! Burn you all! Shoot, says Madrim. We have a problem. Avon says, we must do something. Ruka says, oh no! The protective enclosure is melting. Ruka! Rutus yells. Avon says, Ruka, are you alright? Everyone, run, he says. Nah, that's unfortunate. No, yells Avon. Evil laugh. Hoo ha 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 ha. How magnificent. The purifying flame. You're a sicko, buddy. Madrim says, you. Haha, I'm in a good mood today. I'll keep the fun for later. So long. Really? So long, he says. Darn, he got away, says Madrim. Wait, Avon says, you are Madrim, right? Why did you help us? Don't be mistaken. Bardas is also my enemy. Just like Octum. Okay, so he's like a third... from a third party? Or he is his own party? If you are a dog of Bardas, I won't have mercy on you either. And just like that, he's gone. Rutis says, Ruka! Ruka, hold on! Sister, Rutis, you came back for me. I'm here. Your sister is right here.